Okay, hello everyone. Welcome sa panibago na naman nating lecture. This time, under tayo ng social psychology, pag-uusapan natin yung research methods. Unahin natin yung definition ng research. According to the APA, this is the way you define research. Medyo mahaba, medyo technical intindihin. If I am going to paraphrase this definition, tandaan nyo lang, research is the process of discovering pre-existing knowledge in the world. I want to emphasize on the word discover. Kapag nagre-research tayo, ang goal natin is to discover a knowledge. Yung knowledge na yon, nag-e-exist na bago pa tayo mag-research. Analogy, parang ano, parang ginto. Diba? Research is like gold hunting. Yung ginto, nasa ilalim ng lupa, it's already existing even before you search for the gold. The same thing with doing research. Again, the knowledge that we try to discover about the world is already existing before we did the research. We don't create knowledge. Kasi meron akong mga nakikitang definition on research, knowledge creation daw ang research. I disagree. We don't create the knowledge in doing research, rather, we discover the knowledge that is already existing. Ganyan kasi ang mundo, no, where we are in, where we are doing research in. Knowledge are already pre-existing. In the beginning was the logos. Yung original term na word is logos, which means divine reason. The reasons of the world. So in doing research, ang ginagawa natin dito, naghahanap tayo ng mga reasons about the world that we are in. Ano ang reason bakit sumisikat ang araw? Ano ang reason kung bakit umuulan? Ano ang reason kung bakit ang mga bagay laging napu-pull down via gravity? Ano ang reason bakit ang heart nagbibit? So on and so forth. How do we find out those reasons that are already pre-existing by doing research? We want to search for the truth. We discover the truth about the world that we are living in. Maliwanag. So yan yung pinaka-essence ng pag-research. Naghahanap tayo ng katotohanan na nandiyan na. Dati pa, even before we do research. Now, research is a very general term. Masyadong broad yan. But to be more specific, you can categorize research into groups. Meron tayong scientific research, meron din tayong non-scientific research. Of course, as a psych major, ang mas familiar kayong research would be the scientific research. How do you do scientific research? By using the scientific method. We follow this step by step. Kaya kapag gumawa kayo ng thesis, very soon, you will be doing research and you are expected to use these steps in doing psychological research via your thesis. Ito rin yung ginagamit na method ng mga hard sciences, physics, chemistry, biology, all the other sciences. This is the method that we use in doing research. But remember, meron din tayong non-scientific research. There are also fields of knowledge out there that do research, but they are not using the scientific way of doing research. Like for example, philosophy. Meron tayong tinatawag na philosophical research. But in that research, they are not using this. They have a different method. The same thing with theology. When you study God or ideas about God, hindi naman gumagamit ng scientific method in doing theological research. Meron silang sariling way on how to do research when they discover truths about God. Okay? So yan yung dalawang klase ng categories of doing research, scientific and non-scientific. Okay, but before we move on, before we zoom in to scientific research, after all, psychology is a science, no? Ang implication niyan, if there are two ways to do research, scientific and non-scientific, scientific research is not the only way to do research. It is not the only way to the truth. That's very important. Hindi porket hindi ka gumagawa ng scientific research, ibig sabihin, wala ka ng truth na pwedeng ma-discover. I highly discourage everyone listening right now na kayo maging ano, no? You internalize the value of scientism. Anong ibig sabihin ng scientism? When you assume, when you believe that there is no truth beyond the scientific research. Naniniwala ka, if it's not scientific, if there's no scientific data, therefore, it's not true. That is a very shallow way of looking at our very complex universe. Because to tell you, there are truths in life that are not discoverable by the scientific method. Let that sink in. Because in our culture today, marami mga tao, ganyan ang pilosopiya sa buhay. Kung hindi napapatunayan ng science, hindi ako maniniwala. Eh ang problema, hindi naman lahat ng bagay sa mundo kayang mapatunayan ng science. Especially where? Especially in the field that you are studying, psychology. Remember, the root word of the word psychology is psyche, which is a non-physical element. A little bit of history. Alam nyo ba na itong scientific method na ito, itong steps, the scientific method in itself was created to study or to be used in studying physical elements. Kaya itong scientific method na to, nagsimula ito sa chemistry, nagsimula sa biology, sa physics, common denominator, they are studying physical elements of the world. So it's so easy to apply the scientific method in the hard sciences or physical sciences. Because almost everything is measurable in those sciences. Eh ang problema sa psychology, dahil ang pinag-aaralan natin is the psyche, the spirit that is non-physical, it's so hard to measure. Therefore, mahirap 100% i-apply yung scientific method in studying the psyche. Don't get me wrong, hindi ko sinasabi na hindi tayo pwede mag-scientific method when we talk about the psyche. Pwede. We can capture certain expressions of the psyche through the use of the scientific method. But the entirety of the psyche, the entire complexity of the psyche, hindi kayang mahuli ng scientific method lang. There are times in psychology, you have to go beyond scientific method if you want to have a more comprehensive understanding of how the psyche works. If you want a deeper discussion on that, no, medyo kasi nalalayo tayo sa topic, you watch my lecture on that. You go to my YouTube channel, ang title ng lecture ko is Limits of Scientific Psychology. I explained there how the scientific method falls short in fully understanding how the psyche works. Okay, but then again, let me just emphasize this, hindi ibig sabihin yan na hindi tayo pwedeng gumamit ng scientific method in psychology. Because there are certain variables in psychology na pwede rin namang makapture ng scientific method. And after all, psychology is defined to be a science. It is a science, which means it is one of those sciences where we use the scientific method to answer psychological questions. Okay? So, yan ngayon yung i-zoom in natin ngayon. What are the different scientific ways on how to study things about social psychology? Okay? So, these are the different research methods being used in social psychology. Observation, case study, interview, correlation, and experiment. In fact, if you get a social psychology textbook, di ba ang kapal-kapal niyan, ang dami-daming laman, where are those contents coming from? All the contents of a social psych textbook came from the different conclusions that we generate via doing these research methods in social psychology. Teka, naputol pala. Yan. So, lahat ng laman ng social psych textbook, dyan nang galing yan. From the different research methods that we use. Hindi tayo nagsasabi ng mga truth claims about the social world in social psychology apart from the use of these different scientific research methods. So the goal for today is to show to you in general how each of these methods are being done in the world of social psychology. Let's start with observation. Observation is a process where we passively describe social psychological phenomena. I want to emphasize on the word passive. Ibig sabihin ng passive, yung researcher, wala siyang ginagawa or konti lang yung ginagawa niya in the social world to observe something about the subjects. Okay, so nanonood lang yung researcher from afar what's happening in the social world without interjecting, without influencing that much the social world. As much as possible in observation method, we want to observe social thinking, social behaviors the way it is without influencing this in any degree. Pero yun na nga, minsan sa observation meron ka rin konting gagawin sa social world, no? But mas maganda pa rin yung wala ka talagang gagawin. You just passively describe what's happening in the social world. Now, there are two categories of observation. Pwedeng laboratory, pwedeng naturalistic observation. But for our purposes, we just zoom in naturalistic. Kasi ito yung mas ginagamit talaga sa social psychology. Wherein, ang nangyayari dyan, the researcher goes to certain actual situations in the social world, and then from there, he or she observes social thinking, social behaviors in our everyday life. Okay? Some examples of topics na gagamitan mo ng observation method. Let's say you want to study flirting. How people flirt. How people attract the opposite sex. So, one way to do that, punta ka sa mga bars. Tapos, mag-observe ka from afar, tignan mo kung paano ba mag-flirt ang mga tao. Pwede mo nga rin gawan ng gender difference yan eh. Meron bang gender differences yung pag-flirt between males and females? So, iba yung notebook mo for observing males. Iba naman yung notebook mo for observing females. How they flirt. So, if that's your research question, yan, maganda dyan, observation method. Another research question would be, what social functions do pets fulfill among street dwellers? Karamihan ng mga tao sa lansangan, no? Meron silang mga pets na inaalagaan, mga dogs, mga cats. And you want to ask, ano yung significance? Ano yung social functions ng pagkakaroon ng isang pet kapag street dweller ka? So what do? You go to the streets and then you observe these families na meron mga pets. You observe them from afar. Paano nila tinatrato yung pets nila? O, ano yung nangyayari sa kanila whenever they interact with their pets? You take them down in your notebook and then from there, you answer that question. Observation method yon. Kasi pumunta ka sa streets eh. Tapos inobserve mo sila from afar without influencing them. Okay? Ito, legit study to. Talagang ginawa ito in social psych by Levine and Norenzayan, 1999. They wanted to study how fast the pace of life of different people, specifically different nationalities. And the main way they define pace of life is how fast people walk. How fast can they cover 60 feet? So pumunta sila sa mga streets where merong isang straight path that will cover 60 feet. Hindi ko na lang babanggitin yung mga specifics, no? Haba tayo. Basta these different researchers went to different cities wherein they identified certain streets that will cover 60 feet. And then, nag-observe sila ng mga tao, tinayman nila yung mga tao na naglalakad in covering the 60 feet. So, how long would people cover 60 feet simply by walking? Kinumpare nila yung mga data. You know, some partial results are the following. Sabi nila, sa Canada and Sweden daw, ang mga tao, average of 13 seconds in covering 60 feet simply by walking. O, diba? 13 seconds, 60 feet. Canada and Sweden. Compare that to Brazil and Romania, 17 seconds. So, mas nagmamadali yung mga tao sa Canada and Sweden compared to Brazil and Romania. And the question is why? Bakit yung mga tao sa Canada and Sweden mas nagmamadali compared to Brazil and Romania? Yun ngayon yung aalamin ng mga researchers. Isa yan sa mga topics in social psychology. Okay? So again, yun yung mga different studies na gagamitan ng observation method. Some important tools para makagawa ka ng observation research method, syempre notebook. As you observe, you take down notes. Next, meron ka rin dapat na camera para mas maobserbahan mo yung pinag-aaralan mo, para ma-record mo, no? And of course, in some research or in some observation methods, meron tayong tinatawag na checklist. Listahan yan ng mga social behaviors that you expect to see. So you sit down from afar, and then you observe the social world, and then you check Kaya nga siya checklist. You check whether you observe that social behavior na nakasulat sa checklist. Nangagat, check. Uminit ang ulo, check. Sinapak yung kausap, check. Yun. Checklist ang tawag doon. Okay? Next, case number, method number 2 is called case study. This is another way in doing social psychology research. Detailed description of a psychological case over time. Itong case study, parang observation lang din. Pero, ang case study must involve yung researcher. Remember, in observation, the keyword was passive. But in case studies, talagang the researcher becomes active. The researcher is actively within the case that he or she is studying. Kaya ang pinagkaiba ng case study from observation method is, number one, case studies are more detailed, mas halos, mas marami kang topics na gustong i-focus within a case study, almost everything. Sa observation kasi, isa lang yung pinag-aaralan mo eh. You just want to study flirting styles. In observation, you just want to study social functions of pets. Pero in a case study, you don't just limit yourself into one psychological variable. You want to study almost everything about your case. Kaya nga siya more detailed. And number two, mas mahabang gawin. It takes months. May mga case studies, it takes years. 3 years, 5 years before it's completed. Okay? So, that's how case study is different from observation. Mas detalyado at mas matagal gawin. Okay? Some examples of case studies. Very popular in social psychology, the Wild Boy of Aveyron. So, itong Wild Boy of Aveyron, isa itong bata that they are claiming 11 years isolated from humanity. For some reason, napunta siya sa jungle of Aveyron, somewhere in France. Lumaki siya doon mag-isa with the animals 11 years sa Aveyron Forest. O ngayon, fast forward, nung na-discover siya ng humanity, dinala na siya sa human society, o ano yung mga na-discover nila? Na itong batang ito, yung Wild Boy of Aveyron, when it comes to language, talagang sobrang delayed siya. Which led to the conclusion that language development is highly social. Actually, matagal na nating alam to. Na-reinforce lang because of this case. Diba? So, yung batang ito, dahil matagal siyang na-isolate from other people, super delayed yung kanyang linguistic ability. At merong window period yung language development. There is a certain period in a child's life na yung period na yon, doon siya dapat tinuturuan ng language. Doon siya dapat nakaka-absorb ng language. And once that window period passes by, kapag sumobra na, mahirap nang makapasok yung knowledge about language, which this boy experienced. Lumipas ang window period niya na wala siyang social interaction, therefore, he did not learn any language. Pero sabi nila, no, nung tinuruan naman tong bata na to na magsalita, to learn language, natuto naman. Pero super konti lang. The ability of this boy to use language is not as good as how normal people use language. Kasi nga, lumipas na yung window period. Pwede pa rin matuto ng language pero sobrang konti na lang yung kaya niyang matutunan. Number two, because of this case, we learned that the development of social skills also has a window, just like language development. Oh, kaya nga, one of the effects of being separated from the society for 11 years was hindi siya natuto ng mga social skills. This boy did not know how to converse. This boy did not know how to reason. This boy did not know how to follow social rules. Or he cannot understand why social rules are needed in the first place. Kasi nga lumipas na yung window where social skills must be developing. O paano natin nalaman yung numbers 1 and 2? Because of the case of the boy of Aveyron. Another case, very popular in social psychology, the case of Phineas Gage. Actually, ginagamit din to sa CogPsych. Phineas Gage was a railroad worker. Now, he had an accident while setting up the steel rails. Merong aksidente na nangyari Kasi during those times, for you to install steel rails, it involves explosives. Okay? Now, to make the long story short, merong isang accidental explosion, tumalsik yung bakal na kinakabit niya, tumama sa ulo niya like that. So, a certain part of his brain, specifically the frontal lobe, was damaged because of this accident. O ngayon, I don't know if this is a miracle, no, pero he survived. Etong ganyang itsura niya, nabuhay pa siya niyan. But after the steel was removed from his head, according to the case of Phineas Gage, dinocument kasi siya ng mga psychologists eh. Ano nangyari sa kanya? Nagkaroon siya ng personality changes. Nag-iba yung ugali niya. And most importantly, nagkaroon din siya ng social behavior changes. Naging mainitin ang ulo niya, nawala yung empathy niya for other people, hindi na siya naging sociable, hindi na siya masyado nag-share ng thoughts niya to other people. And because of that case, now, ano ngayon ang implication niyan? In social psychology, we know that social skills are connected to the brain. There are certain parts of the brain that are responsible for making us function in the social world. Meron tayong mga social skills na nakadepende sa certain parts of the brain. And how did we know that? Kasi yan nga yung mga parts of the brain na tinamaan sa aksidente ni Phineas Gage. So those parts of the brains are those parts of the brain are damaged, therefore ang effect na apektuhan yung social skills ni Phineas Gage. O kaya nga ang isa pang implication niyan, it could be that there are some people who are born in this world na talagang poor ang social skills nila. Why? Because while they are developing in utero, pwedeng may mga masamang nangyari in these parts of the brain that handles social skills. More about this when we talk about, when we discuss this in biopsychology. So, meron ding biopsychological component ang social skills. Again, how did we know all this? By studying the case of Phineas Gage. Oh, now, I want to propose another topic na gagamitan mo talaga ng case study. Halimbawa, interesado ka sa mga kulto, lalong-lalo na sa Pilipinas. Bakit may mga tao sumasali sa kulto? Ano ba ang pananaw ng mga members ng kulto sa kanilang leader? O pag-aralan mo yung kulto sa Pilipinas. 'Di ba? I don't know if you have been hearing the news, no? Etong grupo na to, yung leader nila hinuli ng Senate because of alleged illegal activities within their group. So a lot of people are saying na kaya nangyayari yung mga bagay na yan in their group kasi nga kulto tong grupo na to. 'Di ba? So if you are so interested talking about cults, studying cults, one way to do it is to do a case study on cults. And how do you do a case study on cults? You join those cults. You enter their world and then you take note of almost everything that they do inside the cult. Pag-aralan mo lahat na nangyayari sa loob ng mga kulto. Oh. Kapag ginawa mo yung method na yan, again, you are using the case study method. Now, let's move on to interview method. Ginagawa rin to sa social psychology. This is an organized conversation between the researcher and the subject. Ang pinakaginagamit na tool dito is interview guide. Ito yung papel na nakasulat yung mga tanong na itatanong mo doon sa pinag-aaralan mo. Kaya yan yung pinagkaiba ng interview sa simpleng chismisan. Interview is very goal-oriented. It's very focused. You only ask questions that will answer your main research question. Hindi yung patalon-talon ka ng mga topics that we do in everyday conversation. O kumain ka na, o saan ka na masyalong weekend, o nag-aral ka na ba ng social psych, di ba? Ganon sa everyday conversation eh. Hindi interview yon. Ang interview talaga, meron kang research question na gustong sagutin that hopefully can be answered by the answers that your participant will be giving you. Halimbawa, gusto mong pag-aralan yung social pressure as applied in professional athletes. How does social pressure influence the performance of a super athlete? Paano hinahandle? Ano ang pananaw ng isang super athlete kapag meron siyang pressure na nararamdaman every time he or she plays the sport? So anong gagawin mo to answer that question? Hanap ka ng mga super athletes. I-interview mo si Michael Jordan. Interviewin mo si Magic Johnson and all the other super athletes and ask them questions about social pressure. How do they see social pressure? How do they handle social pressure? How does social pressure affect them? Yan yung mga itatanong mo when you interview them. And by the way, alam nyo ba itong research question na to, ginawa na talaga yan. Nasagot na yan in sports psychology. Sinulat yan sa isang libro, The Champion's Mind. Wherein, in this book, marami mga super athletes ang na-interview. They were asked, no, what makes them super athletes? And one of the findings of the book in connection to social pressure is, ang mga super athletes pala, pressure makes them better. They are obsessed with pressure. Ang mga super athletes, nabobore sila kapag walang pressure, when nothing is at stake. They want people to talk trash to them. They want people to boo them. They use the pressure that they receive from others as motivation. Lalong tumataas yung performance nila the more they are pressured. Sabi nga ng mga authors dito, yan daw ang pinagkaiba ng super athletes compared to average athletes. Average athletes, they crumble under pressure. Super athletes get better when they are under pressure. And it makes sense, di ba? Sino bang mga super athletes na kilala natin? In the world of basketball, Kobe Bryant, Michael Jordan, what do they have in common? They are so willing to take the pressure. Di ba? Game-winning shots. Ang dami nilang game-winning shots. Give me the ball. Tumabi kayo dyan. One-on-one. I'm gonna win this game for us. Hindi yan gagawin ng isang average athlete. Ang average athlete, they run away from pressure. So kapag pinasa sa kanila yung bola, and it's crucial situation, most likely, average athletes will just pass the ball to another teammate. But not with super athletes. They have the ball, pressure is high, they love the experience. O, diba? Paano natin nalaman yan? By doing interview research. Another research method we use in social psychology, correlation method. And as you know, kasi nag-statistics na kayo, correlation method is a very quantitative research method. Talagang kinakailangan mo gumamit ng statistics. Kinakailangan mo gumamit ng software. But what's the point of correlation method? The goal of this method is to describe and measure the relationship between two psychological variables. Alam nyo na yan from your statistics class. At least, kailangan meron kang dalawang psychological variables to run a correlation analysis. So, you would like to measure how strong is the relationship between variable A and variable B. And let me just emphasize, no, for you to do this process, you have to quantify. Sa Tagalog, kailangan mong sukatin yung variable A, kung ano man yan, at yung variable B. E paano sinusukat yung variable A at variable B? Alam nyo na yan. In psychology, we use psychological instruments or psychological tests. Kaya kayo nag-aaral lang psychological measurement 1 and 2. For you to know how to measure certain psychological variables. So kapag na-measure mo na yung variable A, na-measure mo na yung variable B, now that's the time that you can run a correlation analysis. O crash course lang ng mabilis on correlation analysis, no? When you run a correlational analysis, you will end up getting a correlation coefficient. Yan na yon, positive 0.93. Ang tawag dyan, correlation coefficient. There are two parts of correlation coefficient. The first is the direction. Pwedeng positive, pwedeng negative. Pag positive, anong tawag? Direct relationship. Kapag negative, anong meron? Inverse relationship between variable A and variable B. Yung number dito represents the magnitude o yung lakas ng relationship. Gaano ka-related yung variable A and variable B? And how would you know if the relationship is weak, moderate, or strong? Meron tayong ranges dyan. As you can see on the slide, here are the ranges of the magnitude. So, hindi ko na kinakailangan i-overemphasize to because you already studied this in your statistics class. Alright? So, some interesting correlational results in social psychology would be the following. Number one, meron palang direct and strong relationship yung heat and aggression. Mas umiinit yung environment, ang mga tao mas highly aggressive. Number two, according to studies, merong inverse relationship ang serving others and the experience of depression. O, anong ibig sabihin yan? Kasi inverse yung relationship, pero strong. It means the more you serve others, the less depression you experience. And vice versa, the less you serve others, the higher the depression that you are observing. Number three, also very interesting, they found out that physical attractiveness is directly related to social treatment. Ibig sabihin, mas pogi, mas maganda ka, mataas yung physical attractiveness, mas maganda rin ang social treatment sa'yo. So, merong social advantage yung mga gwapo at yung mga magaganda. And that can be applied in the world of industrial organizational psychology. In connection to this finding, yan din yung nakita nila sa IO Psych, na yung mga job applicants na magaganda at mga gwapo, mas mataas yung chance na nahahire sila compared to applicants who are not that physically attractive. Totoo pala yun, no? Kaya nga yan din yung sagot sa tanong na why should you dress well in a job interview? So that you look pleasant. Kasi meron palang factor talaga yan. How pleasant you look. How beautiful you look. In terms of how people will treat you. In this case, kapag maganda ang suot mo, how will your interviewer treat you? I-hire ka niya to be in the company. Nagigets nyo? Oh, yan yung correlation method, no? Now, let me just emphasize one thing about correlation method. Marami naman dito, alam nyo na to, but I just want to repeat this because it's very important. Correlation method cannot establish causality. Hindi siya pwedeng mag-establish ng cause and effect relationship. Halimbawa, nag-correlation analysis ka, lumabas, merong direct and strong relationship ang stress and low grades, ang lakas. Tapos positive yung relationship. Are we saying that stress causes low grades? No. Are we saying that low grades causes stress? No. It's just that as one goes up, as stress goes up, low grades also goes up. Mas stress ang tao, mas marami siyang low grades. Mas mababa ang stress, mas konti ang low grades. But we are not saying that stress causes low grades or low grades causes stress. Ano lang ang research method na pwede makapag-establish ng cause and effect relationship? Yun na yung next method natin, experimental research, which is also very frequently used in social psychology. Ang ginagawa natin dito, we gather two or more groups, we influence the groups in different ways and see how will this affect them. Are there group differences that will come out after influencing these two groups in two different ways? Okay, one good example of this, experimental research, ito, yung experiment, yung research ni Albert Bandura, where he wanted to study aggression among children. As we know, aggression is a very common topic in the field of, ano, no, in the field of social psychology. So, gusto niyang pag-aralan, bakit ang mga bata nagiging aggressive? So, anong ginawa niya? He developed the very popular Bobo Doll experiment. I'm sure narinig niyo na yung Bobo Doll experiment, no? Ang ginawa niya diyan, he got 30 children, divided them into two groups, and then he influenced them in two different ways. 'Di ba? The first group, paano sila na-impluwensyahan? They were asked to watch a violent model. The violent model was aggressive towards a Bobo Doll. Doon ang galing yung Bobo Doll. So, yung mga bata nanonood sa isang adult na aggressive, sinusuntok, sinisipa yung Bobo Doll. While the other group of children did not see the model doing things like that to the Bobo Doll. Neutral lang. Walang ginagawang violent yung model sa Bobo Doll. Okay, so 15 children for this, 15 children for that. And then, towards the end, ano ginawa ni Albert Bandura? He put these children into a room where they were left alone with a Bobo Doll. And he observed how children will affect or what children will do to the Bobo Doll, both for these groups. At ano ang resulta na nakita ni Bandura by doing that experiment? Children did exactly to the Bobo Doll what they saw the model did to the Bobo Doll. Ginaya lang nila yung nakita nila. As you can see on the slide, no, ito yung pinakita among children who watched the violent model, no? Ito yung nakita nila in one room, when they were left alone in a room with the Bobo Doll, they did exactly what they saw from the model. At kung mapapansin nyo dito, hiniwalay pa ni Bandura yung data between males and females. Kasi, ang hypothesis niya, yung pagmo-model ng aggression, it's only true for males but not so much for females. He was wrong. Regardless what your gender is, babae ka man or lalaki ka man, as long as you see someone being violent, being aggressive to the Bobo Doll, gagawin pa rin nila, whether they're males or females. Now, for the other group, those children who did not watch a violent model to the Bobo Doll, ganun din nangyari, they were not violent, they were not aggressive to the Bobo Doll. Kaya ang conclusion ng experiment is, ang aggression, it is something that is being modeled to children. Ang isang bata na highly aggressive, most likely aggressive yan kasi minomodel yan ng isang tao in that child's social world. E sino yung pagbibintangan natin? Sino kaya yung tao na yan na nagmo-model ng aggressive behaviors? Most likely, parents. Yun. At sinulat niya yung findings ng experiment na yan in this book. Aggression, a social learning analysis. Ang pinaka-thesis ng libro, aggression is learned from the people who surround us. O kaya nga, ang naging social impact nito, nagkaroon na tayo ng practice that we categorize different shows according to how high the violence is. Diba? Kapag masyadong mataas yung violence ng isang movie, eh gusto natin may parental guidance or we restrict children from watching those movies. Doon ang galing yon, from the finding of Albert Bandura that aggression is modeled. Kaya nga natin sinesensor ng ganyan yung mga movies eh. Para yung mga movies na super aggressive, hindi ma-model ng mga bata. Unfortunately, in the modern society, I'm talking about our society today, mukhang mababa na ang censorship. Marami ng mga aggressive shows that children watch na talagang wala silang restriction. Anong tendency nun when they watch animes like this that are so aggressive, that are so gross, that are so violent? Imo-model ngayon ng mga bata yan. At pag na-model ng mga bata yan, and they move to their social world, there is a high tendency that these children will do exactly. Remember the results of Bandura. Children did exactly what they saw. O ito yung pinapanood ng mga bata, panay ang Dragon Ball, panay ang patayan ng mga anime, yun yung lagi nilang pinapanood. There is a tendency that they are going to apply that in their social world. Kaya pwede mo i-connect yan sa mga ganyang balita eh. Diba, parami ng parami yung mga cases where these things are happening. Crimes where children are involved. Killing someone, murdering someone, and children are involved. Could it be na ito na yung epekto neto? Wala na kasi tayo masyadong censorship. Children absorb these kinds of shows, therefore, they apply this aggression to the social world. To the point na pati yung teacher, sinasaksak na nila. O, diba? So you can, you know, you can theorize, you can hypothesize, you can explain these things by using this idea coming from experimental research. Other popular social psychology experiments that we will also study in social psychology would be the very popular Stanford Prison Experiment. Nandiyan din yung bystander effect. Nandiyan din yung conformity experiment by Solomon Asch. Diba? Ito yung mga interesting, classic social psychology experiments that we will also talk about in this class as we go along. Alright? So again, in summary, ito yung mga different research methods na ginagamit natin in social psychology. Lahat ng alam natin about social psychology, all the truth claims about social psychology in a social psychology textbook, diyan nang galing. Kaya makapal ang mga libro ng social psychology textbooks. Kasi paulit-ulit ginagawa yung mga yan for us to discover social psychology truths. Okay? That's how science is supposed to work. If you have any questions or comments, ilagay nyo lang dyan sa comment section. Sir Howard here. Sana nakatulong tong lecture na to. God bless everyone. Bye-bye.